Just ahead on Tempo, join me at the gym as we recommit our New Year's resolution to lose weight and get in shape. The program is loaded with tips to help you recommit to that plan. We'll meet a co-author in our area who's written a book called Move a Little, Lose a Lot. Selene Yeager has all kinds of hands-on tips that you don't have to use at a gym. Plus, we'll have some quirky weight loss tips for you to help you kind of jumpstart things. A lot of fun going on here. Join us as Tempo starts right now.
Support for Tempo is provided by the members of PBS 39 and by
building a workforce system called PA Career Link Lehigh Valley, training the workforce to meet employer hiring needs, connecting employers with workers, and workers with jobs. Lehigh Valley Workforce Investment Board.
Good evening. Thanks so much for joining us for Tempo. I'm Amy Burkett. We are here at American Hairlines Body and Soul in Bethlehem to help you renew your New Year's resolution to lose weight and get in shape. We do it every year. It's the number one resolution. Even with all of the challenges in the economy right now, people still made that resolution to lose weight and get in shape. And by this time in the season, chances are it's kind of fallen by the wayside. So tonight we have tons of practical information to help you jumpstart your weight loss plan. Tempo's Crystal Fisher tells us more.
Good. There you go. Use your legs. Excellent.
Does your New Year's resolution still have a fighting chance?
Good, all right.
Every year, Mary Lou Nastasi resolves to beat her ongoing struggle with weight. But this year, things got serious.
Time was running out. I turned 50, and all that heart disease and bone fractures, diabetes, was all looking at me. I said, I really have to do something, and I have to do it now. So, I got serious.
Fed up with fad diets and failing workouts, she joined yet another new gym, Steel Fitness in Bethlehem.
All the people there are very encouraging. There's not anybody who looked at me when I went in and, well, there's a fat old lady. It was, hi, how you doing? And they were always encouraging.
Perfect, keep going. There you go.
With a little encouragement and a lot of drive, she started shedding pounds.
I'm more dedicated and I work out, I watch what I eat.
Her original goal topped 80 pounds. According to the Centers for Disease Control, or CDC, just about two-thirds of adults over 20 are overweight, or even worse, obese. Steel Fitness General Manager Mike Kramer says, unfortunately, there's no magic bullet.
If you're committed to the gym, if you're going to commit to your New Year's resolution, you need to commit to a lifestyle change.
Mike names three key lifestyle changes. One, adding cardiovascular activity like running. Two, strength training like lifting weights, and proper nutrition. Mike says the trick to not giving up is mixing it up.
If you come on Monday, strength train. If you come on Tuesday, take a class. If you come on Wednesday, do some cardio. You don't need to be here, you know, 2 hours a day.
When you first start out going to the gym or changing your diet or whatever you're gonna do, it's really easy to quit. Don't. Just keep going.
Mary Lou discovered she loved boxing. It gets her heart rate up and she says it's fun. In addition to beating her extra pounds, she gets out a little aggression.
It's wonderful to hit that punch solid, straight on, to put your whole body and weight behind it, use all your muscles the way they're meant to be used. It's a great feeling. It's powerful. I love it.
Before you start any new activities, Mike recommends consulting an expert. He says your age doesn't always reflect your abilities. Because of our sedentary lifestyles, some 50-year-olds might actually be in better shape than some 20-year-olds. Once you know your level, ask a professional to help you with the strength training routine.
Strength training 3 days a week is what's going to boost up your metabolism, okay? Cardio doesn't, okay? Cardio would burn your calories, but you need your metabolism to jumpstart.
We consulted Lehigh Valley Hospital clinical dietitian Susan Till to help us with the new diet. Her first tip was to be realistic.
New Year's resolutions are always probably, you know, the top of the line. I want to lose 50 pounds by the summer so I can get into my summer clothes. When realistically, you might only be able to lose 10 or 15 pounds. food that I see in food journals is juice.
She says, start journaling your food and drinks right away. You might be shocked about what you're actually eating. Another key, portion control. Many of us are unknowingly over-consuming.
So it's very important to measure your food. Don't leave your measuring cups and your measuring tools inside your drawer. Put them out on the counter so that you can start using them.
Here's an example of how it works. Susan says we should only eat 3/4 cups of cereal for breakfast, this size. But depending on the size of our bowls at home, we might be eating up to 4 times the right amount. All of these changes aren't easy, so get support.
If you tell people about your weight loss goals, then you're holding yourself more accountable to them.
Mary Lou says it's all worth it.
I stand up straight. I walk with my head up. I got to get all new clothes, and I just feel so much better. I have more confidence.
Overall, Mary Lou's dropped more than 40 pounds. She's now comfortable breaking out her little black dress. If she stays the course, next year she won't need to make another New Year's resolution to lose weight. For Tempo, I'm Crystal Fisher reporting.
Thanks so much, Crystal. Well, now that we're all inspired to renew our commitment to losing weight, we're here at American Hairlines Body and Soul in Bethlehem, and my good friend Selene Yeager, co-author of Move a Little, Lose a Lot, joins us right now.
Thanks for having me back.
It's great to have you. Let's talk. We're sitting on a balance ball, and you were telling me before we started that a lot of people are getting rid of their desk chairs and just hanging out in the office on the balance ball.
That's true. There's a whole new breed of science, and it's called sedentary science, and it's looking at what they're starting to call sitting disease, and that we spend easily 14, 15, some people 20 hours a week, not a week, a day, sitting, because we have electronic mail, we have electronic shopping, we have electronic banking. Nobody even gets up anymore. And when you sit for a prolonged period of time, your enzymes that take care of your cholesterol and your triglycerides literally shut down. You go into hibernation mode. And it takes away your energy for just living and being active, but it also is bad for you orthopedically, and it just, if you take the chair away and just stand up, you get so many benefits. And if you sit on a ball, at least you're always a little bit in motion, and you are thinking a bit more about your body and about standing up and keeping your core strength. So it's a good thing.
What else can we do on these balls other than sit on them at the office?
That's a great question. I love these balls because people get pretty bored pretty quickly with their routines. And A, they're kind of pretty and they're fun, but they're a perfect way for strengthening your core muscles, because as you can tell when we're just sitting here, you immediately, like, your spinal muscles have to turn on, your obliques have to turn on just to keep you balanced. Now if you raise one of your legs up, now you got another balance challenge. You can do a little bit. And it just wakes up your body, gets you ready, gets your central nervous system active.
And you feel it in your back instantly.
You do.
Too.
You feel it in your back. And that's where people get really weak, because you're in this position all day, and then you're in this position, and then maybe you're at home in this position. So it's really good to just sit up straight for a change. And it's great for strengthening your abs, which everybody's always trying to do, flat belly, flat belly, flat belly, because you can go all the way back.
We'll let you demonstrate.
And get a nice full extension over the ball, which is better than being on the floor, because your abs actually have to overextend, if you will. And then you can come up, and it's all, you can feel it running all the way down. You can throw in a little side to side and come up. It's a perfect way to work those abs and obliques. And if you want to get a little tricky and work the back side, as we were saying, your spinal muscles, especially in women, some scientists actually think that women over 40 are better served not doing crunches to strengthen their abs or their core, but to reverse it, because we do spend so much time hunched over, and because over time people sort of, especially women, naturally hunch over and their spines start to curve forward. So it's better actually to throw in a little of this.
Uh-huh.
It strengthens those muscles, because when you stand straight, your belly gets tighter and flatter, right? Instead of being hunched over and pooching forward. So if just doing a set of these.
Makes sense. But I think those hurt even worse than the forward crunches.
Hurt is a bad word, Amy. Okay. They don't hurt. No, they should hurt good if they're going to hurt. No, it should be difficult. It should be a little bit of a challenge.
You, but they hurt for me.
It should be a bit of a challenge. It should not hurt. But you can also do a little, again, side, to side, but strengthening those muscles gives you really pretty posture, helps you stand up straight. It's good for your spine, and that's really important for women too as they get older.
And it's more than just cardio these days. You're saying this is every bit as important as doing cardio.
It is more important than doing cardio. In fact, my co-author of Move a Little, Lose a Lot is Dr. James Levine, and he has spent 20 years at the Mayo Clinic in Rochester, so this isn't fly-by-night science, studying sedentary sitting disease. And he has found that people who just get up, and I'm talking get up, talk on the phone, get up, walk down the hall for 150 minutes, that's a little over 2 hours every day, lose weight better than people who, you know, run for 3 or 4 miles in the morning every day. Because if you do that, you just sit all day long. And your body needs those metabolic bumps throughout the day to keep you lean, to keep you healthy.
Selene Yeager, great information. We're going to have a lot more information from you in a little bit.
I look forward to it.
Well, I've got this balance going pretty well just sitting on the balance ball. But next, we head out to Bethlehem's 24/7 Fitness Club for a little, stroll around the park. Okay, it's not exactly a stroll around the park. Photojournalist Melissa Leffel takes us out and about for a spin class.
All right, everybody, let's get warmed up. Remember, every song has a different beat. The goal is to match the tension to the beat.
Free weighing class is just riding a bike. It's simple. It's for everyone. You can be tall, short, round, or skinny, and you can join a free weighing class.
It's a great combination workout. You work out aerobically. You work with Bruce. You work a lot of arms, upper body, so you do a lot of strength work. So I think you work the whole body, and you do it the most efficient way possible.
Nothing better than to see smiling faces working so hard.
It's my sanity. I mean, I do it, obviously for health reasons. I enjoy eating, so, this is a great way to burn those calories.
Remember, fitness is a choice. That's why we're here.
Bruce always tells us fitness is a choice, and I couldn't agree more.
Working out does keep you as youthful as you can possibly be. Helps you keep a quality lifestyle.
Once you start working out and you feel the difference, you will continue to work out. You will. You absolutely will.
There's a good thing in physics. A body in motion tends to stay in motion. A body at rest tends to stay at rest. It's the same thing with fitness. When you do something and you keep doing it, there's nothing better to start your day.
I know it's hard. It's not supposed to be easy.
And I remember as a student, I was probably 255 pounds. And I barely made it through the first class. And I did hear she said I would never come back. Instead of a guy I stayed with, there was nothing better.
Don't be afraid to get out of breath. That's why we're here.
He's high energy, he's motivational, he makes it fun. He makes an incredibly hard workout very fun.
Bruce's class is like dancing on a bike. I love it, it's invigorating, it's motivating, and it's just plain fun.
The energy you get from the people, I give the energy back, and together we make it all work. And that's what's so special about freewheeling.
This is it. Whatever energy you left here, now's the time to get it out.
Well, it's a great rush. It does tax your body. You feel great. I tell people, why do you work out? Because it feels so good when you stop.
It's special to me because at the end of a class and you're done with that last song and you hear and people clap, there's no better feeling. That means I did my job. And my job is to make people feel good.
That's how you start your day. Great job, everybody.
Thanks so much, Melissa. That was no spin around the park. Selene Yeager joins us again. She is a personal fitness trainer. And you've got some fun toys to help us find that motivation that we lack.
I do. Because we were talking earlier that a lot of people, this is when their resolutions just hit the skids. They're all motivated in January. They've got a new program. They're excited. But it doesn't take more than 6 to 8 weeks before that program feels kind of old and they're hitting snooze more and not going to the gym. And so I'm a big believer, you don't need a lot of toys to get fit, you only need yourself, but toys are fun, right? By definition, so it helps infuse a little fun into your routine and it makes a little different, surprises your muscles, and it just works better. So one of the things, a lot of people are getting into kettlebells now, which are not at all new. I mean, they originated in Russia and they're, they used to be kind of ugly and black, but now they've painted them candy colored. So
now it's not like dumbbells, those little hand weights
right, that
we have. This just makes it a little more fun.
And it's fun and very functional. Like if you think about how you hold groceries and how you hold suitcases and stuff, it is like this. I mean, you have a handle and you're picking it up, which makes the weight hang a little lower, so it's a little more challenging, but it also makes you stronger for daily life, like picking up suitcases and grocery bags.
And these are a little heavier than they look.
They are much heavier.
I've got the 10-pound, and you've got the 15.
And this feels even heavier than 15 pounds. But a couple of really nice full-body exercises you can do with them. One is called the tipping bird. You'll like this. It's like those birds that drink water on the boardwalk at the beach.
You know what I'm talking about.
So you just tip forward on one leg.
Pick a leg, any leg. And the weights pull you down.
And the weights pull you down. And you can feel a nice stretch. And then it strengthens. So it stretches you and strengthens you at the same time. It's a good move.
It's about balance.
Yeah. And which is the first thing, Amy, to go.
It is
your balance.
Look, I'm gone.
It's
I should have practiced one
before we started. Yeah, you should get these. So that's one of my favorite moves. It's a full body thing. It wakes your body up. And then you can get, I know you hate lunges, so we won't do a full lunge.
Great.
But we're just going to do a little dip and fly. We got a bird theme going here.
You're pulling your arms out when you fly.
Like wings.
Oh, gotcha.
Yeah, so.
Okay, this I can do.
Yeah.
I have more balance.
See?
And how many do we want to do?
You know, 10 to 12 is always a good range. It's good to get a little muscular strength and endurance at the same time. So do 1 to 2 sets. Don't kill yourself, but it's really nice. You can also use them like, you know, just do the stuff that you would do with dumbbells, with kettlebells. So
great.
Great toy.
Next step.
Medicine balls. Also not new. Also really fun and functional. Really great for strengthening your core. Just try a little swing. On the other side. And do you feel that working?
Oh, yeah.
Here? And if you want to put down yours, you can throw them to each other. So.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Yes, ma'am.
Turn it.
Oh, here's
the it.
Okay, once you get it the first time, it's not so
Isn't
bad.
Isn't that great? And a little chest pass.
It's a big basketball.
It is.
Very heavy.
And
how much does that weigh?
This one weighs 8 pounds, and the one that you had weighed 6.
Okay.
And again, like what I like with these is they're very functional. You pick things up, you put them overhead, you twist, you turn, and it's a full body workout with just one ball. And you can incorporate it in your whole routine.
Selene Yeager, fitness coach, thank you so much for this information. You've got more for us coming up in just a little bit. But still to come on Tempo, we've got some quirky weight loss tips for you. Welcome back to Tempo and our program here at American Hairlines Body and Soul in Bethlehem to help you recommit to your New Year's resolution to lose weight and get in shape. Selene Yeager joins us again with some great tips, and we've introduced you as a co-author of fitness books. We've introduced you as a personal trainer, and now I have to talk to you about being an Ironman.
Thank you.
You won an Ironman competition and competed in Worlds in Hawaii.
Yes, in Kona, that is true.
It's amazing, and that's why we love you. We don't look like you, but we love you, and we want to help learn a few things that those of us at home who are not going to compete in an Ironman, but that we can get in shape and feel better about ourselves and have more energy.
Right.
Something as simple as a band can help us do that.
I know you love the bands. And, you know, I love the bands, too, because they take up no space. You can have them at home. You can travel with them. And you can do all your exercises that you can do in a gym with a band. So, you know, there's really absolutely no excuse. So if you put it under your foot and just start, you can do your basic arm exercises.
Okay.
You got that going?
I got it.
There you go. Curl it up. You got it?
I do.
There you go.
You
got
to hold it.
Yeah, you got to hold it. You know, and just curl. And the thing that's different about bands that actually make them a little more challenging is you can feel you have that resistance all the time. So as with a weight, when you lower it, gravity's helping you out. The band is always pulling a little bit, so it's giving your muscles a little extra something for your time. And if you want to just, you know, raise it above your head, you can also work your back muscles. So keep this one anchored.
Okay.
There you go. You feel that in your back?
Oh, absolutely.
Nice, pretty posture muscles. I love working the back. Most people only work the front of their body, their mirror muscles, as it's called. But it's really the ones in the back that hold your shoulders back, give you good posture, and make you look nice in the mirror. So I'm a big fan of the bands. You can attach them to door frames and do little rowing exercises with them. You can put them under your feet and do squats.
Gotcha.
With them. Yep.
Sure.
You can get a whole, and if you keep it moving, you get your heart rate up and you get a little cardio with it too.
So
So.
A big bonus. You've got another option to talk about, and they're called the BOSU.
BOSU balls, yes. Big fan of these. Most people might not have them in their home, but they're almost at every Y or club at this point at JCC. And they're great. They came out of physical therapy. If you stand on it, you can feel for balance. It's good for your balance. If you want to do a little plie, so put your feet up.
Get a little bit away from each other. That helps. Go ahead.
And you do a little. And you can feel that, your whole body buzzing, and that's a good thing, because that's your central nervous system waking up and saying, we got to get some balance going on, right? And you can work on, let me see if I can do this, standing on one foot.
Okay.
Into a tree.
Excellent.
And a little hops. They're very fun, great for balance, great for getting a little more excitement in your fitness routine.
And it doesn't matter what age we are.
No,
you should always check with a physician.
I mean, if
you've
not been doing anything, yeah, don't be jumping around in there to start, but just stand on it.
So we're working toward renewing that commitment That's to it. Getting in shape, because summer's going to be here before too long. And really what I think I noticed the most, Selene, is I am not getting any younger. And that's a horrible realization.
None of us is.
That's a horrible realization.
But you can make yourself feel younger easily, honestly.
And
a little something every day.
Things are changing. The way that we got used to exercising, we had to have cardio every
right.
single day. Not the case. Everything
no.
we do, and we just need to move.
Just move.
Tell me about the book again.
It's Move a Little, Lose a Lot, and it's based on the science of just moving your body, everyday activities. It's not exercise. In fact, it's called non-exercise activity thermogenesis, which is a big fat way of saying get off your butt and get in motion. Just a little bit every day. It's better than exercising for 30 minutes and sitting for 20 hours.
I think I can do it. Selene Yeager, thank you so much for all of your information.
Thank you.
Now, you know, we know what it takes to lose weight. It's about moving more. It's about eating less. And it sounds so easy, but we also know it's really hard to do. Grover Silcox introduces us to a person who's a stand-up comedian who's made a life out of making fun of his weight. Here's a little bit more.
Comedian Jeff Parami jokes about his weight, but off stage, he's serious about losing some of it.
See what I'm doing right here? Now, here's a tip a guy told me. For a big guy, me doing push-ups and sit-ups, I can't do. They say, get against the counter like this and do push-ups. Do like four or five. I mean, this is, I'm pushing 300 pounds here. Look at it. And next thing you know, hey, the outside feels good.
Jeff performs a push-up with ease, but pushing away, say, a pizza, now that's a challenge. Last year, heart bypass surgery convinced Jeff that good health required more than one-liners. So he began changing his eating habits and lost 30 pounds. He's picked up a lot of diet tips along the way, including the old plate and portion control trick.
Choosing a salad plate instead of a dinner plate is perfect, because when you see these small little appropriate portions on a huge plate, of course your eyes are thinking, that's not enough.
What about juice? 100% juice generally offers nutritious vitamins and fiber, but also lots of sugar. To cut the sugar, Jeff cuts the juice in half with water.
Diluting your fruit juices with water is a great way to save on calories, still get that sweet flavor that you're looking for, but you're also going to be a little bit better hydrated with the extra water.
Many diet and healthy eating experts encourage going right to the source when it comes to fruit.
You will consume fewer calories by eating your apple than you will by drinking a smaller glass of apple juice. When you're choosing 100% juice, you are still getting some good nutrition, but you're not getting the fiber that you would get if you ate that whole piece of fruit. And the fiber is what helps your body to feel satisfied or fuller longer.
People sabotage you. Come on, have this. Or you drive with a buddy home late at night, he wants to stop at Popeye Chicken. You gotta fight it.
When Jeff gets that twinkle for a Twinkie, he checks the impulse by reaching for something with appeal that engages his focus.
Oftentimes, the foods that seem the easiest, we just pour it out of a bag or rip open the wrapper and we eat, are not the ones that have the most nutrition. The healthiest foods tend to be ones that sometimes require a little bit more effort.
You make a sandwich with reduced fat, cheese, and turkey, but you reach for the mayo. But then you think twice and reach for the mustard instead.
A lot less calories, basically no fat in the mustard, but a lot of taste there. You get all the zing that you need.
Another tip, sit at the table and eat your meal.
What we know is that mindful eating, sitting down, taking your time, paying attention to what you're eating, taking the time to enjoy the food, helps you, again, to watch your portion control and not overdo it.
Of course, if you think you're going to overdo it, try this tip.
Brushing your teeth after you eat is a great idea. Once you know that you're satisfied and you don't really need any more, go ahead and get those food flavors out of your mouth you won't feel the need to go ahead and get out a snack.
If you need more calcium in your diet but don't always drink enough milk, try topping off your coffee cup with skim milk and drinking it down to the amount you'd normally add to your Java. Then add the coffee.
That tip is definitely going to help you to boost nutrition, even if it doesn't end up exactly helping you to start shedding pounds.
Let's go back to that pizza. Say the craving overwhelms you. How can you indulge while minimizing the impact?
Patting down your pizza to remove some of the excess oil certainly can't hurt, and the truth is you're not going to miss the flavor and certainly not the extra calories.
And of course, you can cut your losses, or gains in this case, in half.
Something like cutting down on the initial portion size that you put on your plate is a huge help in that area. If you just really know that you're going to have to go back and have a second slice, eating that second half may be enough to satisfy you, but now you've cut down to only one slice total.
You can also downsize portions of certain snacks by rebagging.
Portioning out snacks into little pre-measured servings is one of the best tips that I can recommend for most people who are snack prone in terms of their weight loss.
Here's another tip for when unwanted cravings call. Call a talkative friend.
16, 20, 22, or the two are in college.
Calling a friend and chatting them up is a great way to do it. Another thing that can stave off those hunger pangs is to get up and move around. Do some sit-ups, go for a walk around your block, do something active, and you'll forget about the fact that you felt like eating.
You gotta be ready to take the diet, and when you do it, then you start feeling good about yourself.
Weighing in at 370 pounds, Jeff's now shooting for 300 by following his core plan, using these little tips, and even getting in some tennis. At least in this game, anyway, he won't have to jump over the net if he wins. For Tempo, I'm Grover Silcox reporting.
Thanks so much, Grover. Those are some pretty quirky weight loss tips.
Well, we hope that this evening's program helped you renew your commitment to lose weight and get in shape. I know it's exactly what I needed to get back on the program and make things better for myself. Well, from all of us at Tempo, thanks so much for your time and happy working out.
Support for Tempo is provided by the members of PBS 39 and by...
Thank you for watching tonight's Tempo. PBS 39 is your local public television station, showcasing and informing you of events in our area and information that is important to you. But PBS 39 needs your help. The state has proposed eliminating funding for this station. This could greatly impact Tempo. Please show your support for PBS 39 and the local shows we bring to you. Go to WLVT.org and click on Become an Advocate. Fill out your name and enter your zip code. From there, you can contact your local legislators and choose what letter you would like for them to receive. Supporting PBS 39, your local public television station, is important as ever.
Building a workforce system called PA Career Link Lehigh Valley. Training the workforce to meet employer hiring needs, connecting employers with workers, and workers with jobs. Lehigh Valley Workforce Investment Board,